Now that you know that the choice of representation of your data is a bit arbitrary, you might ask, how can you transform from your old basis to a new basis? And this turns out to be particularly easy if we have a new orthonormal basis. Looking on the left, you can see that if you want to find the coordinate for your data point V along the new direction U, you just need to project V onto U and find the magnitude of that projection. We can draw this as a right triangle, and remember that the cosine of theta is the adjacent over the hypotenuse. In this case, the hypotenuse is the magnitude of V, and the adjacent is what we're looking for, the magnitude of the projection. So that boils down to the magnitude of V times the cosine of theta. This should look familiar to you because it's a similar form to the dot product, and it turns out to be exactly equal to the dot product if you assume that your U is normalized. So for an orthonormal basis, actually your new coordinates just come from the dot product. So again, for an orthonormal basis, your new coordinates are the old coordinates dot the new basis vector. And on the right, I wrote that in two equations, but you can actually put them together to have a more reduced form. And if you have more samples, then you can just add those samples as rows. So now you can see that projection to an orthonormal basis is really just matrix multiplication, where you have Y, which is your new data matrix in the new orthonormal basis, is equal to X, your old data matrix, times W, which is a matrix formed by concatenating the column vectors corresponding to your new basis vectors. And now it's your turn to project your data into a new orthonormal basis.